guys, welcome back to another movie review. Today we are reviewing Miller's Girl. Miller's Girl is a movie that has come out in the UK on iTunes and Amazon Prime. Like, you have to like buy it or rent it. I knew it wasn't going to be that great, so I just think. But I was intrigued because I read an article online. This movie's got a lot of controversy because of the plot of the movie, which we will be getting into. But then I was interested at the same time because it does have a pretty good cast. The main leads in this film is Martin Freeman, who obviously I've watched recently in the Lord of the Rings Hobbit movies. And Jenna Ortega, who I know from the Scream movies, but obviously she is massive in Wednesday and stuff like that, which I've never seen Wednesday, but I like Jenna Ortega as an actress herself. Now, she plays Cairo. Now, Cairo Sweet is basically this student who is a student of Martin Freeman's character, Jonathan Miller, who is Mr. Miller, who is a teacher. He's like an English teacher, and he is, trying to guide her. He sees potential in Cairo. He sees that she has good ambition. She writes really well, and he sees that in her. On the other hand, though, Jenna Ortega's character, Cairo, basically sees her as an opportunity with her friend Winnie, who basically, you know, gets into her head a little bit and says, like, you know, you should sleep with Mr. Miller. And yeah, it goes down that route. It goes down the route of, you know, students wanting and fantasizing, I guess, to be with the teacher. That side of it was a bit like, oh, a bit weird, but it wasn't like too odd, if that makes sense. Now, what I mean by that is, you know, watching it was a bit like, oh, you know, Martin Freeman must be in his 50s and she's obviously a lot younger. So in terms of actually like being younger and filming those scenes, it must have been like, oh, a bit weird, you know. But I think it was done in a really particular way. The plot of the movie, as I say, has been getting a lot of controversy and, you know, yeah. And it is a real thing. Like, I honestly think, like, girls fantasize over teachers. Like, I'm not saying guys definitely do, but girls do as well. It is like a fantasy, and yeah, it's like, you know, something that a lot of people, I'm sure, could relate to. There is another side of the film where obviously it does go down a route of, like, you know, maybe saying things that ain't true so that it harms somebody's job and all that, which is probably where the controversy comes from. But yeah, as a film though, I think it's a great film. It's like a really good standalone film in itself. It's a nice small cast, very condensed, very like easy to watch. It does feel a bit like you're watching a movie that should be on Netflix or something like that. So this did come out in cinemas in America. There is no word in the UK that it's on any streaming service at the moment. As I say, you just have to like buy or rent it from the digital platforms. No physical release, nothing like that. So that's the only way to watch it right now. But I will say, like, the film itself was shot really, really well. There was like some scenes in there. There was one particular shot where Jenna Ortega was smoking a cigarette and like her eyes were like lit up by the end of the cigarette, and it was just all black. Like, it looked amazing on my OLED, and like her eyes were just like these little orange like dots there, and then obviously the cigarette thing. So it just had these shots throughout the film that were just really, really good and really well done as well. So cinematography wise I think it was great. There was also a pretty good soundtrack in there as well. It was very like, I was gonna say 50 Shades of Grey, but I wouldn't say 50 Shades of Grey. It definitely was like, I guess, had like a sex appeal, a sexy kind of vibe to the music. But it was done in more of a, I'd say, crime way, if that makes sense. It's kind of like, you know, it gave me crime vibes, like Hawaii Five-O. Like, I don't know, it just gave me those vibes of like 50 Shades crossed over with like, you know, some police drama or whatever. Yeah, but you know, as I say, it was okay. It was a film that should have been on streaming, don't get me wrong. I would have been very disappointed paying 20 quid for this in the cinemas. I think I paid 4 or 5 quid for this to rent, so not too bad. But also, it is what it is. I had 48 hours to watch it and I watched it. I'm glad I watched it, you know, I'm glad I saw it. It is something that was all over things. But rating it then, what will I rate Miller's Girl? Well, I actually gave it a 3-star because I think as a film it is fantastic. It looks great, some of the shots are brill, the performances from both Martin Freeman and Jenna Ortega were great, their chemistry as well I thought was absolutely fantastic. Like, it was brilliant. But other than that, that's as far as it goes for me. I think the plot was a bit controversial and a bit like, oh, at times like a bit of an uncomfortable watch, I guess, because of, you know, the topics that it deals with and all of that. But 3-star I think is a pretty fair score for it. There's a lot of people rating it a lot lower, but I think some of the shots were really, really good, and you know, I appreciated a lot of it. But there it is, guys. There's my review of Miller's Girl. Have you seen it? Have you seen the controversy? Let me know down below. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned for more. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.